Hi guys, welcome back to a brand new piercing reaction video. Oh my gosh. Okay, so today we are delving back into the world of weird and confusing and piercings that just make you go, what? What is happening? You guys seem to really like the first time I did this confusing piercings one, so I thought I'd do like another part. A tiny reminder, just before I do get into this, I have now started doing Twitch. I now do some gaming Twitches streams, which is really, really fun. I did my first one a few days ago. I was playing Doom Eternal and it was so much fun. So my username is twitch.tv/rollywest. I'm all there as a link down in the description and in the comments. So come follow me on Twitch and we can have some fun. But anyway, guys, let's not beat around the bush, eh, and get straight on to these confusing piercings. You don't need your toes pierced. You don't need the webbing in between your toes pierced. Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? So I just pierced the webbing on this dude's left foot. Why would you agree to do that? I don't understand. Like, that is not going to be helpful or good in any way, shape, or form. That is never going to heal. I don't understand as a piercer why you would do that. Like, why would you do that? Years and years and years ago, when I was like 18, I tried to get the webbing in my hand done here. My piercer took my hand and said, I am not doing that for you. It's stupid. Thank God. Thank you, Felicity. You're amazing. But like, why? The fact that this piercer was like, yeah, sure, let me pierce the webbing of your toes is just stupid. Like, why would, I have never once known a piercer that would have done that. Oh my God. Oh my God. What's that? Wait. What is happening? What the hell? I have never in my life seen someone who wants to get like they're trying to get an anti-eyebrow or something and like have it inside out. That looks absolutely terrifying. Like, what the hell?
I cannot imagine trying to pierce here. Can you? Oh, just get your hands and just do this. Like, just squeeze it. It is so tender, but also incredibly thick.
I can't imagine how much it would be irritating to have like a bit of metal there in your face as well, like on the inside. Oh my God, what's happening? Oh, okay, that's not real. Okay, that's not real. I couldn't even react then because I was just like, I was so upset because I was like, what the hell is happening? That's just some like prosthetic or something. Oh my God. That was like, I'm gonna have a heart attack. No girls. I feel like I look very ghostly today. It's very spooky. Halloween ain't over for me, bitch. What? Now, I've seen a lot in these videos over the years. Never in my life did I think I would see a f***ing cocoon butterfly coming, like, this has given me Drag Race flashbacks when Asia O'Hara, I think it was Asia, tried to do the butterfly release thing on her final. Like, no, leave creatures out of your piercings, okay? Like, this is, just leave them alone. Oh my, what is happening? What is happening? No. Oh my, is this a bad tattoo or a bad piercing? Both. What? Why have you pierced your nipples and hold them together with a... I get that you're trying to be funny, but that's just so gross. Like, it's just gross. It's just gross. Like, it's just gross. It's just gross. It's just gross. No, I don't like it. Oh, good gracious. What the... What is this? What's happening? What's happening? It's all fun and games till someone loses an eye. Had a freak accident today. Okay, it was an accident. Oh my God, I thought someone was like trying to do like a funny piercing for a second. This is a lock, Gale. No, at least it was an accident. This wasn't meant to happen. Oh my God, what? Wow. Ooh. I cannot even imagine the healing process of this piercing. So you've got a snug piercing that goes into a rook piercing that goes into your top helix piercing. What, like, we all have an industrial, but this is gonna be so difficult to have. Like, I don't know what happened afterwards, but I cannot imagine that lasted very long or that healed very well. A normal industrial going through just like the top and the bottom part of the helix is hard enough, let alone a snug piercing. And snug piercings are already incredibly difficult to heal. To go for a rook and then a forward, like up the top helix. Like, that was a choice. We'll say that. It was a choice and hopefully it was okay for you, but that is not something that will heal very easily at all. Oh, for God's sake. Why? You don't need knuckle piercings. You do not need knuckle piercings. This is so stupid. That will literally last a month maximum and you will whack it out your body. You will do like that is, oh my, knuckle piercings. No girl, no girl. Wow. Can you imagine just your hand like this and you're doing this and you have like a piercing here? Just hold on to your bit of skin here like this and then do that. And oh, there's literally no give whatsoever. Like that is not going to last in your, oh my God. Oh, wow. Like, I've seen transverse lobes. I think it's transverse lobes, which is like basically like a horizontal lobe piercing that kind of goes through the lobe, like sideways like that. Something about this looks very strange and I can't work out what it is. Like it looks like maybe this person just had an abnormally long earlobe. I don't know, but that just looks strange. I can't imagine that. I don't know. Do you know, when I first heard about eyelid piercings, I genuinely thought it was a joke. I was like, no one is stupid enough to pierce their eyelids. And then a little time went on and I started to see more photos and I was like, sure. It's just someone being silly, you know, they've heard about eyelid piercings, they're like, lol, let's do it for a laugh. And over time, I've just seen more and more and more. And now, like, it's just like, what are you doing? This is so stupid. Do not pierce your eyelids. I can't believe that is something that I even need to say. Oh my... We love a smiley face. How did you get that in? I don't understand how you managed to get that into... How did you get that in your body? What? Like, how did you get that in your body? I don't know how you managed to get that in. I mean, that's literally never gonna last. Like, that's gonna last I'm just saying like a week. There's so much pressure being put on that area. That's just gonna come out. Like, if you don't rip that out within the first week of having it done, that's gonna reject from your body so quick. Quicker than Grandpa Joe jumping out of bed as soon as he found out that Charlie won a golden ticket. What the hell is this? So first of all, we have a butterfly and now we've got someone with butter. What? I just don't, a breakfast to go. I don't understand, like, live your life, girl. Oh, for God's sake. I can't do this. I don't think I can do this anymore, guys. Like, 2.5 years of doing these piercing stuff, I think I just need to just go and jump off a bridge. At what point did someone go, do you know what? Do you know these things that are in my mouth? You know, the things that are very, very vital to, you know, by kind of like living, like chewing, it affects your speech. Like, all, you know, most people will say that their teeth are incredibly important to their life. I'm going to shove a needle through the middle of it and put a bar there because, you know, I don't want my teeth anymore. Choices were made. Bad ones at that. No. Oh, for God, it just gets worse. This can't be. Please tell me this isn't real. This is like the quality is not very good. It's hard to tell, but that has to be fake. Please tell me that isn't real. I love that the caption of this is just no. Guys, I've said it before and I'll say it again and I'm going to say it again and again and again and again. No piercing is worth losing your teeth over or damaging your teeth. Like, it's not worth it. The cost of dentistry is astronomically higher than having a piercing and it is really not worth it. And I know I always get people who say this, but you've got two lip piercings. Yes, and I've had these for 10 years. And if for a second, 1 second, it gave me an ounce of bother, I would take it out, but they haven't caused me any bother. Emphasis why I no longer wear my labrette piercing, because it gave me bother and I took it out. These do not hit against my teeth at all. But if they gave me an ounce of problem, I would get rid of them in a heartbeat, because there is no way in hell that that damaging your teeth is worth a piercing. Now, I have seen this before. I don't know whether it's been in a video or not. I will never understand how you got that in your head. How did you get a bar in your head? And the thing is, it looks like it's almost like a healed piercing. Like, there's no bumps, it's not bleeding. It's not like someone just shoved that through and it's like, lol, look at my head. Like, that looks like it's been growing out. There's a saying, if you can pinch it, you can pierce it. And to a certain extent, it's kind of true in a way. It's obviously not a good idea to do motorfaces because, you know, you could pinch bits of skin anywhere. And I'm not going to say go pierce your stomach. I don't get how you managed to pinch any bit of skin back here. Like, I literally have zero give, like zero give at the back of my head. How did that happen? Oh my God. What? That? I don't know what I'm more confused about. The fact that you managed to stretch your bridge. Like, bridge piercings are notorious for growing up very fast. You know, the surface piercings, you know, you move your face all the time. But, like, the fact that you've managed to stretch it that large, like, wow. And also, like, does this person have, like, a nasolang piercing where it goes all the way through the middle? Or is it just two holes and it's got, like, half a hoop in it and it's not actually going through the middle bit? It's, like, cut off in the middle. Like, I don't know what's happening. Live your life, girl. Okay, so we have a video. Oh, those anti... Wait, what am I supposed to be looking at? This guy, okay, so this person's got horns, but look at those anti-eyebrow piercings. Look how like gross they look. I don't understand. I get so confused, like why you would also like, wouldn't the piercer be like, look mate, maybe we should look after this? Because if I was like, if I pierce people, right, and I had someone come into me and they wanted to get piercings done and I looked on them and they already had piercings that looked gross that they haven't been looking after, I would not pierce them, because I'd be like, well, you're not going to look after them. What's like, well, I'm not going to waste this time on you when you're like, you're not going to look after your piercings. Like, I find it very strange that piercers were just gonna be like,
yeah, sure, girl, why not? Lola.
What is this? What? What? I don't understand what I'm looking at. What is that, like flesh? No. Is that like tunneled, but he's got it in his arm? I can't really tell. Like, I can't. What? What? I need someone to shed some kind of light. It says skin tunnel. Skin tunnel is in like a tunnel. Like, what? Again, I don't know exactly what is going on in this image, but let me just tell you, having an open hole into the inside of your body like this would never be a good idea. Oh, wow, so you got someone here with lots of piercings. I mean, good for you if you want to do that, like, live your life, girl, I don't care. Although I do want to say, I don't think putting a safety pin through your eyebrow is a good idea. Guys, please don't put a safety pin through your eyebrows. They're not designed for jewelry. And there's like a couple where like, they're really holding on by like a thread and you've got like bumps and stuff. Guys, if you're gonna do loads of piercings like this, look after them, because it'll just look gross. And again, don't use things like safety pins as jewelry, because they are not designed as jewelry and you can get an infection very easily. Oh, for the, oh. I have never in my life seen someone with an armpit piercing. An armpit piercing. What? What? Sure. Why not? Why wouldn't you want an armpit piercing? Can you imagine? I mean, there is literally, if I feel here, there is just like, I can just feel like tendons and like muscle tissue. Ow, that would hurt so much, so much. Well, also that wouldn't last for long at all, because you'd be rubbing it all the time. You would like, that will just come straight out of your body. Well, guys, I'm well and truly aboard the trigger train. Choo-choo, speeding down the railway, about to crash over a cliff and plunge to my death. Bad bitch, oh my God. Like, how does this, I just don't understand. I just don't get it. Like, half this stuff is like, what are you doing? Like, what? Why do you need to pierce your armpit? Why are you piercing, you know, the webbing of your toes? Like, I just don't. I can't. No.
No, girl.
So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please hit the like button, because it's really, really helped me out. Share with your friends. Hit the notification bell if you are new. Subscribe, all that good kind of stuff. Don't forget, I now am on Twitch. So come down below, follow me on Twitch. We're going to play, I think we're going to play Banjo-Kazooie next on Wednesday. That's going to be my first like retro game we start playing. So I'm going to play through Banjo-Kazooie. I'm currently on my modern game. I'm playing through Doom Eternal. So they're the two that I'm doing at the moment. So come follow me on Twitch. It's a great laugh. All the guys are like talking to each other in the chat as well. It made me so happy seeing. So thank you for everyone who has followed me on Twitch so far. And everyone else, come follow me. Rolly West on Twitch. There's a link down below. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. And of course, as always, a massive shout out to my gorgeous Patreons, whose names you can see on the screen here. Hopefully I have not missed any out. I've been slightly stoned this month, so I do apologize. But thank you for everyone who is my Patreons. But I do want to give an extra special shout out to my top tier Patreons: Alicia Marie, Ash Page Wynn, Angela Justice, Becky Hederman, Brenner, Cassie Hill, Cat0808, Chill Herman, Christopher John, Robbie, Corin Pemberton, Demetra Settle, Heather Marie, Jay Elia, James Burgess, Joyner Price, Julie Seymour, Kat L, Kelly Bowser, Kelly P, Chloe Louise, Laura Perlicek, Magusta Lagoose, Moragain Ewolf, Nandra, Robin Stoutenberg, Samuel Patterson, and Suz Mac. Thank you for being my top tier patrons. Of course, as always, there's a Patreon link down below as well if you'd like to become a patron. And yes, I've got merchandise available. And here are two more videos if you want to watch two more videos, girls. But anyway, guys, do fast, amazing, be gay, be everything you want to be. And don't let the bitch out there tell you that you can't be. You. Why is that? Because you are flawless, girl.